In this class, we are going to see about the importance of manure and fertilizer.
Manuring or biomanuring. Organic manures are predominantly derived from plant debris, animal feces, and microbes. They make the soil fertile by adding nutrients like nitrogen. Few of them are listed below. Animal manure. It consists of feces and urine from livestock like cattle, horses, pig, sheep, chicken, turkey, rabbits, etc. Manures from different animals have different qualities and different applications. Farm yard manure. It is a mixture of cattle, dung, urine, litter, materials and other dairy wastages. On an average well-decomposed farm, farmyard manure contains 0.5% nitrogen and 0.2% available phosphate and 0.5% available potash. Sheep and goat manure. It contains higher nutrients than yard manure. It contains 3% nitrogen, 1% phosphorus pentoxide, and 2% of potassium oxide. Compost. Compost is a soil conditioner as well as a fertilizer that is rich in nutrients. It is produced by natural decomposition of organic matter such as crop residues, animal waste, food waste, industrial and municipal waste by microorganisms under controlled conditions. Green manure. Green manure is obtained by collection and decomposition of green leaves, twigs of trees, field buns, etc. Green manure improves soil structure, increases water holding capacity, and decreases soil loss by erosion. It also helps in reclamation of alkaline soils and reduces weed proliferation. It is a manure obtained from undecomposed green materials derived from leguminous plant, example sun hemp. Biofertilizers. Biofertilizers are substances that contains living microorganisms which, when applied to seeds, plant surface or soil, colonize the rhizosphere or
the interior of the plant and promote growth by increasing the supply or availability of primary nutrients to the host plant. Types of biofertilizers. Rhizobium. Rhizobium is a soil bacterium that colonize the roots of leguminous plants to form root nodules. The bacteria fix atmospheric nitrogen and converts them to ammonia. Azospirillum. Azospirillum has the ability to use atmospheric nitrogen and transport this nutrient to the crop plants. It is inoculated on maize, barley, oats, and sorghum crops. It increases productivity of cereals by 5 to 20% of millets by 30% and fodder by over 50%. Azotobacter. Application of Azotobacter has been found to increase the yield of wheat, rice, maize, and sorghum. Apart from nitrogen fixation, these organisms are capable of producing antifungal and antibacterial compounds. Mycorrhizae. These fungi have symbiotic association with the roots of vascular plants. They increase the uptake of phosphorus, example citrus, azolla. Azolla is a free-floating aquatic fern found on water surfaces, having a cyanobacterial symbiotic association with Anabaena. It is a live floating nitrogen factory using energy from photosynthesis to fix atmospheric nitrogen. Biofertilizer scheme. Tamil Nadu government has recently launched biofertilizer scheme. It is aimed at better management of natural farming and helps to boost and maintain soil fertility.